Hey everybody, this is Jay with JT Adventures. I'm doing a knife review on the Kabar Heavy Bowie. Kabar Heavy Bowie, this is our first knife review. And so I'm starting out with one of my favorite knives, the Kabar Heavy Bowie, from the wonderful company Kabar. We have a couple of Kabar knives, and they all come very sharp out of the package, very nice, and high quality company, and they always have nice edges, and I dig them all. Let's start off with the sheath. The sheath is a nice leather and Cordura sheath. I've got three knives that are leather and Cordura sheath. This, the K-Bar Kukri, which we already have a video out on, and the Ontario Marine Raider, which we will show you in one of our next videos. So the front is Cordura. The back is leather, very nice leather. It's smooth, feels good, as well as the belt loop is leather and the clasps. The sheath is, you know, it's not the most amazing sheath in the world, but it's, you know, it's nice. It's, I dig it. It has nice studs, nice sewing, and I put some nice 550 paracord on mine so I can secure it to my leg as well as on the hilt of the knife, which I'll get to in a minute. My brother got a K-Bar Heavy Bowie too. He put a pouch on his to store stuff in, as well as paracord wrapped around, which I actually like on my due to mine, and as well as he's got green paracord on his and on his handle. But as you can see, his buttons are slightly different than mine. His are both faced the same way, and mine are faced different ways, and I'll explain that. See, on the handle of this, I'm going to take out the knife. Right here, the buttons, they swivel, which I actually don't like all that much because they kind of, you know, move around and get annoying. The only thing I do like about that is you can decide whether to put it the way his is or the way mine is, which I like mine this way because then I can, with both fingers, flip it out. It's on a D-ring, which, once again, I'm not a big fan of because it's kind of skinny. It's not a big, heavy-duty D-ring, unlike my Marine Raider. And the belt loop isn't very wide, and it's kind of small. But overall, you know, great sheath. The leather on the inside of the button things are kind of crappy. The black paint is kind of wearing off. But other than that, I mean, it's a really nice sheath. When the knife is secured in here, the D-ring, it doesn't swivel, which I'm not really sure why they put it on there, but they did. And so that's the sheath. I like the sheath. Now onto the knife. The knife is 9-inch blade, which I really dig. I dig big knives, as you'll see. I've got three big knives and one or two little knives. I'm a bigger kid. I like bigger knives. And so it's 9 inches on the blade. It's 14.5 inches overall, and which means the handle, obviously, is 5.5 inches. The handle is Kraton, and which is really nice. It's sticky in the hand. It's all smooth, and it's comfortable, and it doesn't move around in your hand. I've got leather handle knife, and it kind of is not as sticky as this. I like this. The blade is 1085 high carbon steel, which I'm not really sure why they decided to do 1085 steel. I prefer 1095. That's what I've mostly got. I think all my other knives, except for my cold steel super edge, which you'll see in another video, is all 1095, and I really dig it. 1085 is good. I'm not gonna lie, it's good. It's a good steel. It's better than, you know, some of those other steels, like 1055 or whatever. And but I'm not really sure why they decided to do it on this. I guess it's a little bit more soft. It's a little easier to sharpen, and it holds a really good edge, which I'm impressed with. It's it came out of the box extremely sharp and very nice, and so I really like the way they put it together. It's got a 20 degree angle, so I mean, the knife overall is 1/4 inch thick, which is a very thick knife. But and then they have a 20 degree angle, which is amazing. I've got another knife, the Ontario Marine Raider, which is the same, about the same thickness, but it only, but it has a lot broader degree on it, an angle on it, and it's epoxy powder coated, and it's full flat grind, which is really nice. It's great for batoning. It blows wood away. And the Tang stamp, I don't know if you can see, it says Taiwan, which is, you know, it's all right. I prefer it made in the United States, you know, just as better quality, but, you know, what can you do? They decided to do it Taiwan, it's cheaper for them, and it says Kabar right there on that side. It's the same quality, it's still high quality knives. There's no true guard on it, it's just kind of more of a block right there, just to keep your hand from sliding onto the blade, which is still cool, I'd still dig it. The sweep of the blade is really nice. Obviously it's a Bowie, but if you look at it, it kind of sweeps up right there and then back and around, which I think is actually way cool. It's good for the cutting and chopping. It kind of gives it a nice area to grab onto. And on the handle, there's a nice lanyard holder, which I connected to a lanyard to mine. It's just safer. It's not going to slip out of your hand when it's wrapped around your wrist. There's a little bit of a false edge on the top, not a whole lot. I mean, it's still pretty thick right up there. You're not going to be able to sharpen that. It's not there for sharpening. It's just there to, I don't know, looks or to for stabbing, stuff like that. Which, this isn't exactly a fighting knife. It's not all that heavy for its size. You would expect it to be heavier. It's not that heavy. And so it's good. You could use it as a fighting knife, but it's not made just for that. It's more of a survival, utility, tactical knife, all that stuff. And so I really dig this knife. I think anyone should have it. It's great. I actually ordered mine in August, and for some reason they were impossible to find. I ordered it from a couple different sites. All of them were unavailable. And I finally got mine in November or October, late October, early November, which I wasn't too happy with, but like they had a shortage or something. It's a pretty popular knife. It's really nice. So I recommend anyone to get it. It's a great knife, and look for more of our reviews. There will be a demonstration on this knife, and so look for that. And it's a great knife, and so get one. They're cheap, only $40, and go out there, get a good knife, and use it.